Ding, ding, ding. That's the seatbelt ding. Yo, Tall Bike Tommy here, and Merry Christmas, everybody. I am doing what I feel is my good deed for Medicine Hat before I head to Halifax for a week. I'm going to head out in a couple days here now, but I was on the internet bulletin board, Medicine Hat's Kijiji, and I saw a posting where a young man named Cody is asking for a ride home. Well, he needs a ride to Calgary so that he can get his flight and get back home to see his family. So I'm at the Medicine Hat College right now, where I'm about to meet up with this guy Cody, make sure he's legit, and say hello, ask him a few questions, and if we could find somebody out there who is going to Calgary or anywhere you know, beyond Calgary and north of here for the 20th, if they could get him up there, that'd be great. I'm gonna find out what time his flight is, and then I think he said he's back on January 2nd, and then he'll need a ride from Calgary down to Medicine Hat on January 2nd, so we're gonna try and organize that stuff for him. If one of the fans can help out there, that'd be totally cool. That's what I'd really like to have happen. If it doesn't happen, I might just get the shuttle for him, but hey, is that Cody?
Hello.
Hey.
And then he'll be like,
that's our man right there. I'm ambushing him. I don't even think he knows I was going to film him.
But if I'm complaining, that obviously means that it's not working.
Yes.
Anyways, I'll let you go live your life.
Okay.
Cody, nice to meet you.
Hello.
Where are you from?
Here, Medicine Hat.
And where are you going when you get on this plane in Calgary?
Kelowna.
Kelowna, okay. So you have family in, that's in BC, right?
Yes, and kind of family. They're what I have for family.
Yeah? Mm-hmm. And what are you studying here in Medicine Hat?
Everything. UT Science. So right now I'm in first year, and it's biology, chemistry, I've got sociology, English, and calculus.
So you spent your last probably 3 weeks completely studying, doing finals, all that stuff?
That would be ideal. I'm trying. I'm super bad at it, so, and I still have three more finals on Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, so yay.
So this is Cody. He needs a ride on, you said, on the 20th?
The 20th, and my plane leaves at 8, so.
8 at night?
Yes.
Okay, so that gives you a lot of time. If anybody's going any time on the 20th,
yeah,
then give
them
a ride.
I've been harassing people for weeks on my Facebook and friends, and everyone's going on like the 17th and the 18th and the 19th and the 21st and the 22nd.
I'm going on the 18th, and I thought to offer, but then I thought, well, I mean, if this guy's got nothing
I've got
to do for 2 days.
Well, I've got a commitment on the night of the 19th.
Okay.
So, like, I have to...
You have to find a ride for the 20th, all right? So if anybody out there is heading to Calgary on the 20th, anytime during the day, or if they're going beyond Calgary, if they're going to Edmonton, wherever, give this guy a ride up to the airport, and he'll much appreciate it. But I think the interesting thing is ride sharing is an interesting experience.
I never knew about it, and I keep asking, like, because I was asking my friends, and they're like, well, why don't you catch the shuttle? And it's like, I spent all my money on a plane ticket.
Yeah.
And then just yesterday, my one friend was like, oh, you should do rideshare on Kijiji. And I was like, I don't even know what that is.
Yeah.
And then I found it.
It's basically like digital hitchhiking. Mm-hmm. I mean, like the people who are on Kijiji most of the time anyway, you know.
Are you studying for bio?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Another student just came by.
Have the test on the same day.
Same day, yeah. How did you think?
Another biology student.
Other one, right?
But yeah, so I was talking about rideshare. I know a friend of mine, 18 years old, hitchhiked from Halifax all the way to Vancouver, and he stopped in Medicine Hat and he did a little video with me. This is about 2 years ago, but the experiences that he had and the people he met while traveling, he said was way more valuable. Like he said, he's gone on flights and, you know, paid for the train before and stuff like that, but it's about the culture of people that are interested in sharing.
Yeah, you know? And I think it would be fun if I did that, like for like the whole trip type thing, but so far, the past like however many years that I've went, I always catch a Greyhound, and the 17-hour bus ride just kills me.
Ugh.
And so both ways, and it's just like, I just want to just die. It's terrible.
Totally, I agree. The Greyhound is not ideal. I mean, if you got to go somewhere close, or if it's the only option, yeah, it's the last option. But
and like, it's super nice and cheap, but planes are also exciting, so I'm excited about the plane.
This is a first time for Cody. Is this your first time going on a plane, or your first time catching one on your own?
On my own, I did when I was younger, but it was like a really long time ago, and I don't remember very much.
Well, like the whole experience of flying is like the airport and the airport security and all that stuff. And when you're a kid, it doesn't matter.
That's the most.
But now that you're an adult, like, it's the thing that matters.
I can
bring
my laptop and just normal things with me, and I just feel like they're gonna be like, search him, and then rip my bags apart and be like, we found this fork. I don't know.
Last time I traveled, I had a pair of scissors taken away from me. The pair of scissors was too long. They have a little measuring thing on their shirt that they use to like measure it against. But you gotta take your laptop out and like put it in a separate container. You can't put anything else in the container with the laptop, because if you do that, they'll be like, no sir, you can't put your hat and then the laptop thing together. No, that's a no-no. You just like laptop in one container, all your other stuff in another container. And then they like walk you through this little thing, and then it always dings, and then they like put wand you down a little bit, and then usually they're like, go. But worst case scenario, they stop you and do this thing where they check your hands with this like little suave thing, and if you've played with fireworks in the past 6 months, it'll like go ding, 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 and then right away you've got more questions to answer. Good thing, yeah. Cool, cool. All right, well, I guess so, and then you're coming back, you said, January 2nd. Mm-hmm. So is there a rush to get back to school? Do you have a class on the 3rd?
No, like class, because the 2nd is, I think, a Friday. Because class starts on the 5th, which I think is a Monday.
Okay, so if anybody's in Calgary on the 2nd, anytime, if they want to bring them back down to the hat, that'd be cool too. I'm sure somebody will be able to organize that by then. I mean, we got plenty of time. Somebody that I know on either the Facebook page or the YouTube channel is in Calgary, definitely, and wants to come down and visit, and we'll do that on the 2nd. I'm sure of it. Cool. All right, I think I've bugged you long enough. I'm gonna go let you like get some sleep and do some more studying and all that kind of thing.
More studying.
Cool. Anything else you wanna say? Any messages you wanna give to anybody before I cut this off?
Any help is greatly appreciated, and I never expected this kind of response. So thank you.
Cool. All right, I'll leave you alone. Have a good night.
You as well.
Later, Cody. Hey, that was fun, ambushing a guy at college while he's trying to studying for his finals and all that. Well, I hope everybody who's watching has some way that they could help, if it's just sharing this on their page, or you've got a ride that you can give or something like that. Like I said, if my fans can't do it, I'm gonna end up doing it myself. Share this video, like and subscribe, subscribe on YouTube, Facebook page, Community TV. I'm Tall Bike Tommy. Thanks for watching.